Mina, konbanwa, JesusFreakinGamer here, coming at you with 2 Chronicles chapter 25 tonight. We're going to start, there goes the bookmark. We're going to start at verse 17. Now Amaziah, king of Judah, asked advice and sent to Joash, the son of Jehoahaz, the son of Jehu, king of Israel, saying, "Come, let us face one another in battle." And Joash, king of Israel, sent to Amaziah, king of Judah, saying, The thistle that was in Lebanon sent to the cedar that was in Lebanon, saying, "Give your daughter to my son as wife." And a wild beast that was in Lebanon passed by and trampled the thistle. Indeed, you say that you have defeated the Edomites, and he had. And your heart is lifted up to boast. Stay at home now. Why should you meddle with trouble that you should fall, you and Judah with you? But Amaziah would not heed, for it came from God, that he might give them into the hand of their enemies, because they sought the gods of Edom. Essentially, what Amaziah did after he defeated the Edomites, he took their idols and he worshipped them, which I don't understand that at all. Like, if you beat these people and their gods didn't save them from you, why are you going to turn from your god and worship them? That, I don't know what was going through his mind. Kind of like yesterday, I really don't understand this. This does not make sense to me. There are genuinely some arguments, like, against God, against Christianity, that I think are legitimate questions, I think are good, good solid points. I read stuff like this, and I'm just like, okay, that's just weird. I don't see where they're coming from at all. But the point I really want to focus on is the fact that he did conquer the Edomites, and then he went up against the kingdom of Israel. And Israel was like, dude, stay home. You're not going to win. And he went up anyway. Now, if God has determined destruction for you, you're kind of done. You're kind of finished. There's not much you can do about that because you can't oppose God. And his heart was hard. He was told to stay home, that his heart was lifted up. He's not going to listen to the guy he wants to fight. He's going to be like, oh, he's just taunting me. He's just kind of, he's provoking me. Bring it. Let's go. It just makes him all the more anxious to go out there and fight. And what I would like to encourage to those of you who will listen, who aren't so stiff-necked and aren't so hard-hearted, and if you are a little stiff-necked and hard-hearted, try getting a massage. And try to I don't know, maybe even get like some kind of chest massage as well. Unstiffen that neck. Unharden that heart. Be open to different ideas. Be different to reason. Try to seek out some humility. If you've done something and you've done it well, that's great, that's awesome, that's wonderful. No one can take that from you. But just because A went well and you know A and you're good at A, that doesn't necessarily mean you're going to do well at B and be good at B. Like for me, you've seen my channel, I'm decent at action RPGs, old school side scrollers, some shooting games on lower difficulty levels. But that doesn't necessarily mean I'd be good at FPSs. By the way, I'm not. I suck at them. Just because I do halfway decently on computer stuff and internet stuff, that doesn't mean I'm some elite hacksaw Nova 420 blaze it. Pew, 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 pew. Doesn't mean any of that. What I'm good at, I'm good at. But I have limits. I have limitations. There are people better than me, and I need to recognize that. And same thing for you guys. You know, you're good at what you got. You have your victories. We have our limits. We can't do anything. And there needs to be a check in us where when we hear someone say stop, that we listen. And we do stop, and we realize, you know, we've hit a bound, we've hit a limit. And that can certainly apply to moral and ethical matters as well, where it's like, okay, you've done this, you've gone this far, that's well and fine. You go much further, you're kind of treading into some bad territory. Same thing. I guess the overall point would be twofold. One, you know your limits, know your boundaries, know how far you can go, be aware of what you're not so good at, and also, just have an open heart. Be humble. Be ready to listen. Maybe even to some people you don't really like. Because even though they don't actually like you, some of the things they point out about you, reasons they may not like you, as hard as it may be to listen to from your enemies, it might still be true. It might still be accurate. And that And to listen, especially to someone you're not too fond of, it does. It takes humility. It takes a soft heart. And I've certainly been guilty of not listening myself before. It's not the easiest thing to do. So I'm encouraging you and I'm encouraging myself. Look at my own video. Look at the picture of myself on OBS as I'm recording right now. Brandon, you listen to this too. This is important for you. Be soft-hearted. Listen. Even to your enemies. Listen. Even to your enemies, guys. It can be important. So, guys, thank you very much for watching this episode, this video. I love you. God bless.